Dear students, Jai Hind and very good morning. Welcome back. As you all know that we are in the chapter Understanding Shape. In the last lecture, if you can remember, we have been discussing various types of problems. And if you can remember, in our last lecture number 20, we discussed all three examples which were in fact the testing of the basics of properties of quadrilateral as a general that we have already discussed. Okay. Now, what we are doing in today's lecture? We are continuing solving some of the difficult examples, understand, based on concepts of various types of quadrilateral. In solving these examples, as usual, today my target is that once you are given any example, okay, then I want it to be an instantaneous self-practice by giving the similar examples here on the board, so that it happens that maximum self-learning practice will benefit you a lot, because once the sum, any example has been explained to you here on the board, when the content is fresh in your mind, you will be able to solve all the example quite easily, understand, and quite clearly. That's the concept, understood? So, dear student, let us continue in today's lecture number 21 in the chapter 7, that is Understanding Shape. Okay. Today also, dear student, let us solve some difficult numericals. Okay. Based on the concepts of properties of various quadrilateral. Okay, just now we are writing the sum number 1 again. See what is given in this example. First, once I write any example here, understand, I am giving you and keeping the pace of writing in such a way that you can see the example on the screen easily, and you can be able to write the sum easily. That's why we are keeping that pace for you. The question I am writing, find, just note down, find all angles of a, just first note down the sum, find all angles of a parallelogram, find, this is the question, find all angles of a parallelogram if two adjacent angles, if two adjacent angles are congruent. You understand this? First, dear student, I have seen one that when we are explaining and speaking in video lectures and we are writing any content on the board, understand, it may happen like in live classroom where you can follow the faculty and able to write instantaneously. That's why I always give you time to note down the sum which I have written here. Understand? And a moment pause for you only, so that if you are not able to write the sum with me, now you can write it. What is given? Find all angles of a parallelogram if two adjacent angles are congruent. Okay, this is the data given to you. Okay, dear student, how can we solve as far as geometry example are concerned? Please make a practice commonplace to at least draw the simple diagram. Understand? Because in geometry, the diagram in many examples will help you a lot to conceptualize the sum very easily. Okay, let me draw one simple, okay, parallelogram. This is parallelogram we have drawn. Okay, let me name this parallelogram as A, B, C, D. Okay, now dear student, what is given in the data is that in this particular parallelogram, two adjacent angles are congruent. So, because dear student, as we have been doing in previous lecture also, that we are supposing x, either if you do not want to suppose x and you want to do it yourself, I am always welcoming the variable method from student. Don't stick to the method, because I have to teach generally to so that all the students can understand, but smart students can solve the same example in some variable manner also. Understand? That's accepted. It's not like that you stick to any particular method. So suppose, dear student, I target these two adjacent angle as equal. Can I take them as x? Definitely. Understood? I am taking both angle A and angle B as x. Understood? Now let us write in. You must be remembering the symbol of parallelogram. You know that, though not mentioned in textbook, but we can take it. In parallelogram ABCD, two angle you suppose, let me write angle A equal to angle B, and then you will write let angle A angle B equal to x degree that we have supposed here. Dear student, A and B both are equal angles and supposed as x. Now let us, you remember one general property which applies to all quadrilateral except trapezium, that in all quadrilateral, I am reiterating some of the facts again and again to enhance some of the concept and ideas and basics in your mind forever. Understood? So what I have been speaking, what we know, that except trapezium, in case of all the quadrilaterals, either parallelogram, square, rectangle or rhombus, the sum of any two adjacent angles is 180. That you should remember for always, except trapezium. Understand? So let us, dear student, utilize that property again. Can I write this way? Angle A plus angle B equals to 180 degree, because two adjacent angles are supplementary. Let me write the value x plus x equal to 180 degree. 2x equal to 180. Understood? Just cancel out 180 upon 2, that is 90. So dear student, value of x you got, that is 90. Okay, now there is no question of substituting A equal to x, that is 90 degree, B equals to also x, that is 90 degree. And now dear student, one more property of parallelogram comes to our help. Which is that property? So as you know that property very well, that opposite angles of a parallelogram are equal or congruent. That T we already have remembered and implanted, understand, in our mind. Let us write angle A equal to angle C. But dear student, when you write in exam this way, that angle A equal to angle C, if you want to score the full marks, here you need to produce the reason at least. When you write angle A equal to angle C, you can write opposite angles. Understand, that is sufficient because you know that we are solving an example of parallelogram. So you do not have to mention the full fact like opposite angles of a parallelogram are congruent. The full statement we don't require, but at least when you say that angle A equal to angle C, you should mention the reason. How can you say that angle A equal to angle C? That's the main point. Therefore, angle C equal to 90 degree. At the same time, dear student, you also write angle B equal to angle D. Again, the reason they are opposite angles of parallelogram, therefore D is also 90 degrees. You first you write down, then I want to discuss one very important basic with you. First you just note down the sum. First you write the sum, then I want to share one thing with you. Understand? Okay. Have you noted down the, have you calculated the sum in your book? Now the important fact which I want to share with you is this. Parallelogram. We found all angles from given. Now, dear student, what is important is that from the given data, when you calculate example and you got angle A 90 degree, angle B 90 degree, angle C 90 degree, angle D 90 degree. That simply means that all angles are right angle. Can you guess the quadrilateral which is formed from this given fact? It was initially a parallelogram, that you all know. Based on the given data and utilizing properties of parallelogram, you are able to find all angles as 90 degree right angle. That means, dear student, because parallelogram, opposite side parallel, opposite side equal, that you all know, which is also an intrinsic property of rectangle. What is that? Opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are congruent. That is also the property of rectangle. But it was now turning into rectangle, because all angle we found are 90 degree. You understood, dear student, a very important fact we need to understand and share. This parallelogram now becomes a rectangle. So suppose in exam, if I want to ask any MCQ or fill in the blanks, am I able to make fill in the blank or MCQ from the given data? Yes. When you got all angle 90 degree, when given condition was in parallelogram to adjacent angles are equal. So, am I able to make one very important statement? What is that? If in a parallelogram, two adjacent angles are equal. I am speaking it. See, I am narrating the same example in the format of fill in the blank, MCQ, true, false, whatever you think. If in a parallelogram, two adjacent angles are equal, then it becomes rectangle. You understood this? This way, dear student, MCQs are designed. From the theory you are studying, it is not like that, that MCQ comes from out of the blue. That is not going to happen. Even in maths, in science, anyway, whatever MCQ comes in front of you are those MCQs which are actually designed from the theoretical concept you study to test your basics. You understood? Is it clear in your mind? So one fact, please note down at the end of the sum as a special note. What you will note down? Any parallelogram having two adjacent angles equal congruent is known as rectangle. Understood? So is it? Let us go for one another example of parallelogram. Okay, another example. But before you solve the next example, your mind has to be very, very clear. What is that? That the sum of adjacent angle is always 180 in any quadrilateral except parallelogram, except trapezium, sorry. Now, one more example based on parallelogram, and one thing clear. This example, one example we will solve here, okay? And one example for self-practice. Understood? Just example number two. Okay. One more example is on parallelogram. Okay. Let us write. This is the question. Two the okay the measures of the measures of note down the song first the measure of two adjacent the measures of two just note down measures of adjacent angles of a the measures of two adjacent angles so note down the sum, dear students, some technical fault. The measures of two adjacent angles of a parallelogram, the measures of two adjacent angles of a parallelogram is 4:5. The measures of two adjacent angles of a parallelogram, this way you should write, are in ratio or in proportion, you can write, are in proportion or in ratio 4:5, then find all angles. Okay, first dear student, note down this example. What is given in the data, that first you need to see. What is given here? The sum of measures of two adjacent angles of a parallelogram are in proportion 4:5, then you have to find all the angles. Dear student, again in solving this particular example, again there will be the concept testing regarding the properties of parallelogram. What is that? Adjacent angles of any quadrilateral are supplementary, and another property of parallelogram, as you know, that opposite angles are equal, that you know. We are in solving this particular example going to utilize the same facts, same properties which we have utilized in solving previous example. And dear student, mind it one more thing. Once I solve this example for you, I am going to give you one another example for self-learning practice just now. So, dear student, when I am solving the sum here on the board, please be attentive. Understand each and every statement so that you are able to solve the example quite easily. Okay? Let us first draw a simple parallelogram to comfort us in solving the problem. This is parallelogram, okay? Let me name this parallelogram as parallelogram ABCD. Now, in this, dear student, two adjacent angle that you can take any one, either AB, BC, CD or AD. Let us take A and B. What has been said? If you select angle A and angle B, they are in what proportion? 4:5. Let us start the sum in this way. Okay. First, you will write, let in, you will write this way symbolically, in parallelogram ABCD, you can write this way, angle A is to angle B equals to 4:5. Okay, dear student, because two angles are in proportion 4:5. Understood? You must be knowing whenever such proportion we have to take, you can write this way, let angle A in terms of x, dear, angle A equal to x, angle B equal to 5x. Okay, now you all know very well that adjacent angles are always supplementary. So, can we use that property here? Definitely. Angle A plus angle B equals to 180 degrees. Let us substitute the values. 4x plus 5x equal to 180. Now we will not write degrees. 9x equal to 180. Follow the pace with me and please go on writing with me. 4x plus 5x, 9x equal to 180, x equal to 180 upon 9, that is 20. So, dear student, we got value of x as 20. Now, it's a simple question of substitution. I am writing it again here. X equal to 20. Okay. What is angle A, it is given that angle A equal to 4x. You understood, dear student? 4 into what is the value of x? 20. This turns out to be 80 degree. Clear? You should learn and you should strengthen all the basic understood, even if you have were a little confused in substitution. Mind it, make yourself very strong. Then B, that is equal to 5x. Let us substitute 5 in bracket 20, 5 20 ja 100 degree. A we got 80 degree. B you got 100 degree. And one thing you all know very well, that one more property of parallelogram, dear student, what is the opposite angles are congruent. Can we write as we wrote in previous sum? Angle A equal to angle C. Please write the reference for accepting this. You can write opposite angles. Okay. Therefore, angle A we know, so angle C we know, 80 degree. Similarly, student, write for another pair of opposite angle, angle B equal to angle D. Please note down opposite angles. So you can write angle D equal to 100 degree because B is 100. Please follow this sum. Note down the sum in your book properly. At the time of explanation, if it happened that you might not be able to catch my pace, understand? Because at that time you may be just comforting yourself to understand the sum rather than just writing it. So, dear student, please look at the sum and please note down. Because one such example I am going to give you just now as a self-learning practice. But first, please have a look at this sum. No confusion should prevail in your mind. Understand when you solve this particular example. Understood? The examples which you are solving in quadrilateral understanding shape now might be again a repeat in 9th standard. Understood? So if your concepts are clear now, will help you a lot in upper standard. Okay? Clear? So one example just now for SLP, okay. You have to note down the sum with me and then you will try to solve this, okay. Let me write the sum for you here and then you will try to solve it, okay. Let me write. Okay, write with me. Example number 3 in today's lecture. The measures of the measures of two angles of a please note down measures of two angles of a parallelogram the measures of two angles of a parallelogram are in proportion five is to seven then find all angles. Okay, dear student, sum is little bigger, so enough time of 4 minutes for you. Please try to solve this by yourself. Understand? First, dear student, calmly note down the given data in your book and then try to solve it. We are giving you again 3 to 4 minutes time to solve this particular example. Try this out by yourself. I am exiting out of screen not to defocus you. When you solve this particular example, okay? Read the data and try it honestly by yourself. Just understand the data and try to solve this particular example. What has been given in the data? Measures of two adjacent angles. But dear student, we missed the one word here. Please note down that two adjacent, that's compulsory. The measures of two adjacent angles of a parallelogram are in proportion 5:7. Then find all angles. Understood? Just try this out by yourself. 1 minute has elapsed. Now just 2 minutes more to solve this particular example, and then as usual, if you can't, we will solve it here on the board. Understood? Just look at the sum and try to solve it. While you solve any sum, please be very strong in your content and in your basics. Understand? Then you are able to solve any example easily by yourself. And we are giving much importance, no doubt. All chapters are important for study, but much importance too. This particular chapter, the reason lies in this is a chapter of geometry and you need to make your basics very, very clear as far as geometry is concerned. Understood? Just 1 minute time now left to solve this particular example. Understood? Right? Make little fast. Utilize the concepts you learn and try to solve this particular example. Understood? Okay. Your time is over now. Let me solve it. Those students who are able to solve, please just verify. Understood? CDS student, first a simple diagram of parallelogram as usual. Okay, simple diagram of parallelogram ABCD. Two adjacent angle, you can target any pair whatsoever you want to do. Understand, just now we are targeting A and B as usual. In statement are also important, dear student. In, that is compulsory to write. In parallelogram ABCD. Now you will write, dear student, this way, angle A. You might have written it also, those who are able to solve. 5:7. Okay. Therefore, angle A equals x. Angle B equal to 7x. Okay, and then dear student, as usual the statement, as you know, as we know that, as we know that angle A plus angle B equals to 180 degree, because the adjacent angles, as you know, are supplementary. Let us write the value. 5x plus 7x equal to 180. Add both the like term, 12x equal to 180 degree. Divide 180 by 12, 12, 15 just. So dear student, you got the value of x as 15. I am just writing it again, x equal to 15. Now it's a question of simple substitution. A equal to 5x, 5 into bracket 15, that is 75 degree. B equal to 7x, 7 into 15 equal to 105 degree. And again, dear student, the concept of opposite angle, A equal to C. Reason you every time need to produce opposite angles. Therefore, angle C equal to 75 degree. In the similar way, angle B equal to angle D. Again, the reason, dear student, opposite angles. Therefore, angle D equal to 105 degree. Please keep pace with me and please note down this. Understand? Just look at the sum. many students might have been able to solve this example themselves. So they, what they just need to do is a simple verification of the sum which they have already solved in their book, and the rest of the student, I actually accept that all student needs to be able, I expect that all student can solve the example by themselves if they are alert enough and attentive, understand during the lecture, they might be able to solve this. Then it's a simple question of just the verification only. Understood, dear student? Is it clear in your mind? So, in today's lecture, what we have solved were some of the difficult examples. You understood, dear student? So, for today's lecture, be alert, make your concepts clear, practice the sum at home. Understand, dear student? That's a very must for you. Okay, thank you very much from Bharat sir.